Welcome back. You know, one of my favorite things about making this film was getting to come home to the great state of Tennessee to make it. Matter of fact, I got so excited when it was confirmed we were coming to Tennessee, I wrote a song about it. Back to Tennessee, you got it. One of my other favorite memories, there's a spot in the movie that Miley and I sing this song. Some people call it the butterfly song. Some people call it the caterpillar song. No matter what you call it, it sure tugs on the heartstrings.
And action.
How's the song coming?
I don't know. I'm not sure yet.
Can I hear it?
You tucked me in, turned out the light. Kept me safe and sound at night. Little girls depend on
the butterfly song is so fabulous. When I listen to it every time, I like get a little misty and don't even know if I can sing it just because the words are so real and so honest, and the song just kind of captivates you.
Everybody's familiar that, you know, a caterpillar becomes a butterfly. It was just right for this movie. First time I heard this one, it was like Chill Bump City. I said, yeah, there's your song right there.
Probably the most stirring song is Butterfly. It's a duet between Miley and Billy Ray that's just beautiful.
It's a song that it shows Robbie saying to her when she was younger, when she was just a little girl, and she tries to, you know, turn it into an actual real song. It's very like unique because it's a song that's specifically just to show her dad how much she loves him.
This little girl's grown up, you know, and it's time to spread her wings and fly.
Butterfly, fly away.
It's a beautiful song. It's so simple. It really blows you away. I think a lot of people will be very surprised by her vocal range.
Butterfly, which is an incredible composition, and it's a father's kind of angst about letting his little girl go.
It really just shows growing up and just how it really feels like time does go by so fast. You've got to embrace every moment.
Rascal Flatts sing Bless the Broken Road, which is such a warm, fabulous song.
I'll never forget that night, sitting on that porch with Rascal Flatts, and they were perfect. It's no wonder they're so successful and the vocal group of the year.
We were thrilled to be asked to be a part of this film. I think it's going to be huge.
The idea of them being in the movie was just fantastic. And then they were such great guys, and they came to the farm location and hung out for 2 days and played and riffed with Billy Ray on the porch. It was just fantastic. And just the idea of them being in the movie, it adds so much.
For us, you know, with shooting in Tennessee, we live, you know, 45 minutes down the road, you know, and this scene that we're in, like sitting around at a birthday party, you know, playing with the family guests, playing music, that's how we grew up, you know, so it's just like being at home.
Rascal Flatts was so much fun to have around because they are so silly. They're very much like my dad, where my dad like just loves music and likes to goof around, and so that was really cool for me to be able to have them around and people that are such, you know, bring such smiles to everyone's faces.
It's grandma's birthday party. It's a rocking party.
Oh yeah.
You get your house back, you get your dog back, you get your best friend Jackson back, you get your truck back, you get your hair back, you get your first and second jobs back, your front porch swing going daily.
I'm really excited about a lot of things about this movie. I get to make a cameo, I get to perform. We're gonna slow it down for this next song, if that's all right.
Oh my gosh, I cannot say enough about Taylor Swift.
She's so talented and gorgeous and sweet as can be, so we were happy to have her on our set.
Taylor contributed a song called Crazier, which she wrote herself.
I wrote the song Crazier when I was 13, and so this song is really a reflection of what I thought love was supposed to be. And, you know, sometimes you write a love song about what you hope will find you and what you hope you'll find someday, not about what you're actually going through. I wrote the song in hopes that possibly it would be in the movie, but I never thought that it would be such a big, prominent song. It's absolutely one of the most exciting things. This song is playing when the main characters of the movie, Miley and Billy Ray, they're both falling in love with that song as a background. It's really cool to have that kind of a part in the movie.
I like this idea of a song that taught a dance that taught a song that taught a dance, and the result was the Hoedown Throwdown.
It's Miley's Macarena, where Miley jumps on the stage and leads the audience through this incredible sequence of dance moves. Pop it, lock it, polka dot it, country fighting, hip hop it, put your heart in the sky, move side to side, jump to the left, stick it, glide.
The Hoedown Throwdown. You know, Miley was incredible. She came in, she probably picked it up within an hour or so, maybe even less than that. I was impressed.
Because I've been dancing for so long, like, I pick it up, I have, like, one of those photographic memories, so I'm, like, recording it, and then to remember, I don't know how I do it. Pop it, lock it, polka dotting, country fighting, hip hop it. But everyone else, I'm like, sorry, Lucas, but when he does the polka dot, I crack up every time. It's like the whole room would be shaking like he's doing it, so it's so funny.
I felt like I was doing an 80s workout video. I'm having a tough time with it, but I'll get it eventually. So it's a pretty fun dance to do.
And then I got to watch Jason, and Jason is just so silly. He's like, I can't dance, so I might as well make people laugh. So it's great.
Jamal is an amazing choreographer, but he is much better in person than he is on the DVD, because we got little DVDs where he teaches us the dance.
I had to learn it watching it on TV, and I felt ridiculous in my trailer doing this by myself.
Oh, man. I didn't know. So, I mean, it looks really, really low budget.
Hey, everybody, this is the Hoedown Throwdown instructional video.
And it looks like he's doing it in, like, a 4-foot by 4-foot cell. I mean, there's no room. He's doing all these moves up into the wall, and funny is funny.
But from what I understand, everybody learned it from this DVD, and it's like the hot stuff right now, you know. I wanted the audience to feel like if I learn this, I'll probably be really good at it, and I'll probably look good doing it. And it's simple enough for everybody to participate.
At some point, everyone will have to do the Hoedown Throwdown.
I've seen a lot of the dancers doing the Hoedown Throwdown, but I took one look at that and said, that ain't my cup of tea. Let the dancers dance and the singers sing. That's my motto. Throw it all together, that's how we roll.
Up next, we'll take you back to the set of Hannah Montana the Movie for the performance that had the entire cast and crew in tears. Don't go away.